Hello children, let us learn about rolling and sliding objects. Before that, let me tell a story about wise grandmother.
There was a lamb going to see his grandmother. On the way through the jungle, he met a wolf. I am going to eat you. Please let me go. I am going to see my grandmother. You can eat me when I return. Okay, you may go. When he was about to return, he told the grandmother about the wolf. The grandmother gave him an idea. Go and hide yourself in a toilet. He did so. The grandmother rolled the dholak on the road. The dholak started rolling down. The lamb saw the wolf waiting for him. Did you see a lamb coming this way?
No.
The wolf grew suspicious and started running behind the dholak. Before the wolf could catch him, the lamb reached home and was thankful to his grandmother. Wow! As I told you, grandmothers are always wise.
In the story, what happened to the dholak? It rolls down. Do you know which objects can roll and which can slide? Objects with round surface can roll. It means if we keep it on a slider, it will go around itself. Objects with flat surface can slide. It means if we keep it on the slider, it will not go around itself. It just slides down. Let me demonstrate this. Here I have an exam pad, scale, pencil, stapler, onion and sharpener. First, I am keeping the exam pad in slanting position. Consider this as a slider. Now, I am going to find whether these objects can roll or slide. Let me try with stapler first. Keep the stapler at the top of the exam pad. It slides down. It means stapler can slide. Now, let me try with scale. It also slides down. It means scale can slide. Now, let me try with pencil. It rolls down. It means pencil can roll. If we keep the pencil in standing position, it slides. Next, try with onion. It rolls down. It means onion can roll. At last, let me try with sharpener. It slides down. It means sharpener can slide. My dear children, you can also try this activity at your home with the things you can get from your surrounding. Thank you.